Welcome back to The Lead, and time for our money lead. What were you doing when you were 14, besides figuring out those awkward years of puberty, maybe babysitting for some extra cash, working a paper route? How about proposing a way to save the government hundreds of millions of dollars? I know why wasn't, but that's what Suvir Mirchandani has done. He has just published a report in the Scientific Journal of Emerging Investigators. Yes, he's a teenager and has already had his work published. That says that the government could save $234 million just by switching the type of font they used in printed materials. So with Congress constantly bickering over what should be cut from the budget to save money, this sounds like just the thing they need here in Washington. Suvir, thank you so much for joining us. This has got to be an exciting moment for you at 14. You got to tell me how you came up with this idea and explain to our viewers how you do it, just by changing fonts in official government documents.
Well, thank you so much for having me, and definitely it's very exciting. So what I propose is that the government switch the font that they're using for all their documents to a particular font called Garamond. And throughout my investigations, I found that this particular font can save a lot of money and a lot of ink. And my research led me to conclude that the government could save almost $234 million simply by switching to that one font. That's because the font is thinner, it's lighter, it just simply uses less ink. Just simply looking at it, you wouldn't be able to tell that it actually saves 30% of ink costs. So those were my conclusions.
So it's ink, but it also uses less paper, right? Because it takes up less space? Because we came across this statistic that the average federal employee prints roughly 7,200 pages per year, 30 every workday. So that's a lot of paper if you're filling up less paper with that ink. So is that part of the calculation?
It's not part of the calculation that I determined, but that's definitely a byproduct of switching to this thinner and more lightweight font.
Well, it's a smart idea. Have you heard at all back from the government printing office in response to your idea now that it's been published out there?
Actually, I sent a query to them at the beginning of my study about some information that I might need for this study. Unfortunately, they didn't respond until I was done. So I had to obtain that information from some publicly available research documents. Right now I'm simply working to, you know, spread the word.
Well, it's good you're spreading the word. Did they give you an answer? Did they say they're considering this at all?
No, they haven't. But my goal is just to get a few individuals to change, which would personally save their ink costs.
Well, and maybe it's something we can all follow, right? You know, think before you print, as they say, and this is another way to save it. So I know that this project came from a science fair last year, I think, but there was another fair today, and you got a whole new project. So tell us what it is. I mean, you got to be, you know, figuring out a way to move us all to Mars or cure cancer. What have you come up with this time?
Well, this year I created a web browsing system that the individuals with motor disabilities can use. So even though they can't use their limbs, they use eye tracking and brain control to navigate through a web page. So when the user concentrates at a link, the web browsing system determines which link they're looking at and navigates to the link for them.
It reads their minds or it reads their eyes as they're looking at their computer screen?
Well, the brain control is done using electroencephalography, and that measures brain waves. So I'm just measuring attention levels using the MindWave mobile headset. It's not reading their minds, no, but I'm also using eye tracking to determine where they're looking.
All right, so you're 14. You've already come up with two great ideas. I'm proud of you. Thanks so much for coming on, Suvir Mirchandani, joining us from Pittsburgh.